Ah yes, websites. There are at least 1,000 of them, but which ones are the best? Obviously, I can't really answer that, but I can at least tell you about some that you should definitely know about. In this video, I've got 11 cool websites that range from being extremely useful to just pure fun. You've probably heard of some of them, but I doubt all of them, so you should at least get something out of this. And links will be in the description, of course. Quickly though, before we begin, I'm just gonna give a quick 2-second shout out to my Twitter and Instagram. I try to post cool stuff on there if you're interested. It's just @TheoJoe for both of them. Anyway, let's get started. Number one, this website is definitely in the extremely useful category. It's called VirusTotal, and you may have heard me mention it before. It's actually owned by Google now. And what it does is lets you upload any file, and it will be scanned with pretty much every virus scanner software out there, which is over 60 of them. This obviously can't replace having antivirus software on your computer because it only scans individual files, but it's great if you come across something suspicious. Maybe you download something and your antivirus software says it's fine, but you want to be sure. Or maybe your antivirus says it's a virus, but you think it could be a false alarm. In both cases, you can use VirusTotal to compare it with all the other antiviruses out there to get a better idea. Like, if every antivirus says it's fine except a few, then those are probably false positives. But if you get a pretty good chunk of them saying it's a virus, you better play it safe and not run it. Also, they even have a feature to search websites as well. So if someone sends you a link that you're not too sure about, you can check it out. Of course, common sense is the best defense, so don't rely on it completely. If it's a brand new phishing site or something, I don't know if it would be able to detect it. Next up, we have a quick one that's just for fun. It's called Windows 93, which emulates a theoretical version of Windows that would have been from 1993. It's not exactly historically accurate. In fact, it's mostly just humorous, but is actually surprisingly complex. It has an internet-themed Wolfenstein game, a drawing program like Paint, even Half-Life 3, which apparently never finishes loading. And you can also start a virtual machine, which runs Windows 93 inside Windows 93. There's obviously a ton of stuff you can do to waste time on in here, so I'd better not get too far into it. You can just explore it yourself. All right, number three, this is another important one called Have I Been Owned? It seems like all the time now we hear about a new website getting hacked and passwords being leaked, but how are you supposed to know if your data has been leaked? Well, that's the point of this site. You just type in your email address and it will tell you if your email address, along with your password and any other potential info, was included in any breaches in any of the databases they have. That way, you know not only to change your password on that site, but also never use that same password again. That's because hackers frequently use leaked databases to try email and password combinations on a bunch of sites. So if you use the same password on multiple websites, they can easily get in. Another really important feature of this site is you can sign up to receive an email notification if your email has been found in any future breaches going forward. And chances are you will eventually. Just look at the one from Adobe in 2013, more than 150 million accounts were leaked. You obviously want to know immediately if it happens to you, so it's a neat website to use. Number four, we have a website called 10 Minute Mail, which generates a temporary email address for you that expires in 10 minutes. This is great if you come across a website that requires you to sign up for an account to use it, but you'll probably never use it again, and you don't want to give away your real email. Now, you can just sign up with a throwaway email address, get whatever you need from the site, and leave. Another use might be if you're not sure whether a site is junk or not, you can sign up with a temporary email, and if it turns out to be legit, you can make a real account or change to your real email. On the other hand, if the site ends up being useless, you won't have to worry about getting on any new spam list from it. On to number five. This one is great and is so simple. It's called Down for Everyone or Just Me, or the short version is just isup.me. And all this site does is tells you if any website you type in is currently up or down. I'm sure it's happened to you a million times. You try to go to a site and it either takes forever to load or won't load at all, and you're wondering if the problem is on your end or not. And there's not really much more to say about what it does. If the website's up, it'll just tell you it's just you, and if it's down, it will say it's not just you. Definitely a handy one to remember. Okay, up next, number 6. This one is pretty well known, I think, which is Get Human. And this website is for any time you call customer service for any company and you just can't seem to talk with a real person. With this, you just type in the company and it will tell you exactly what steps to take to get connected to a human customer service agent, assuming it's possible. For example, if we try Sony, it tells us the phone number to call and then what numbers to press that will get you through to someone. In this case, you press 5, then 0, and then 0 again. For companies or websites that have basically no way to talk to someone like YouTube, it will at least have some instructions for how to fix some common problems. And they also apparently have a paid service where they will literally call the company on your behalf, but I've never tried that particular service myself. Alright, next we have an interesting little site called Which Book, and the point is to help you find a book you might want to read or several. On the left of the page, there are a bunch of criteria sliders that you can use to describe what you like. So maybe you want one that's really happy, but also really disturbing, which would be a weird combination. And we can actually see it has quite a few possible recommendations. There is a limit of 4 slider criteria at once, I guess because otherwise it would just be too specific or inaccurate. And there's also a button you can add more settings like specific type of plot, the setting, or character. So overall, it's just a cool site you might want to check out if you like to read. Number 8, Pixabay. This is an awesome stock photo site, except every single one of the pictures are royalty free. Specifically, the pictures are all released under a Creative Commons Zero license, meaning they are released into the public domain. And there are a surprising number of stock photos on here, like right now there's over 1 million. And that's nowhere near some of the paid stock photo sites that might have over 100 million, but hey, you can't really complain, it's free. There are still a ton of really cool high quality images on here that you can use from anything from desktop wallpaper to being put in YouTube videos. You're also able to filter for specific types of images like actual photos or vector graphics or ones that have transparent backgrounds, for example. And yes, I do often get a lot of pictures from here and use them in videos. It might be difficult to find images about really specific topics, but for the most part, you can usually at least find something that you can work with. Number 9 is a site called Just Watch, where you can type in any movie or TV show that you want to watch, and it will tell you what streaming services have it. And as you can see, it supports pretty much every streaming service out there, or at least the most popular ones. Let's do an example. Like for Game of Thrones, in the results under Watch Now, it shows you the services that you can stream it on, assuming you subscribe to them, as well as other services that let you just buy the episodes outright, and how many seasons those sites have. In this case, it looks like they all have 6 seasons, but you want to double check, because even though it says Fandango and Microsoft have 7 seasons, if you actually go to them, they just have the option to pre-order season 7, and you can't actually watch it yet. Now, as I said, it also works for movies, so if we type in something like Doctor Strange, right in the results, we can see that it's streamable on Netflix, and most of the other services allow you to either rent or buy the movie. I should mention that the results will definitely vary by country, but at least it seems like it also supports a bunch of European-based streaming services as well, so it should work no matter where you live. All right, almost near the end, number 10 is Product Hunt, which is a really cool website to find out about brand new products that have just been released or announced. These might be physical products, apps, or services on websites. New products are posted every day, and a lot of them are from random startups you've probably never heard of, but you'll also see people posting stuff released by major companies like Apple or Google, and usually before they're widely advertised. Of course, you can also filter through different categories to see the most popular recent stuff as well. So I think this is a neat site worth checking out every few days or so to see the best stuff that you might have missed. Okay, finally, number 10, we have If This Then That, also known as IFTTT, and this website basically connects the APIs of a ton of different websites and services all together to interact however you want. For example, you could make it so anytime you get a new Twitter follower, your smart light bulbs blink. or anytime you post a photo on Instagram, it automatically posts it to Facebook as well. The possibilities are pretty much endless. You could even do weird, pointless stuff like anytime you upload a YouTube video, it turns your thermostat up or something like that. Completely ridiculous, but you get the idea. The one thing that I will say though is unfortunately it's not always super reliable, so you shouldn't use it for anything important. Like sometimes the triggers might be delayed for several minutes for no reason, or might not trigger at all sometimes. So just be aware of that. Still, even if it is kind of slow, it's still pretty darn useful. So I guess that's it. A bunch of cool websites that I think you'll find pretty cool. And maybe you knew most of them, but you can always send this to your friends to let them know about these too. If you have any awesome sites that I didn't talk about, let me know down in the comments. I'll probably do another one of these eventually. If you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can just click on those. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. Again, feel free to follow me on Twitter or Instagram. Both are just @TheoJoe. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.